Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 17.5 RC, or Release Candidate. iOS 17.5 RC is out to developers and public beta testers on all iOS 17 supported devices. This should be the final version released to developers and beta testers before it's released to the public. Now this update came in at 6.51 gigabytes on my 15 Pro Max, and it's going to be about that size for all the other devices, as anytime you go from a beta to a public version or from a public version to a beta, it's a full install. Now, along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 17.5 RC, watchOS 10.5 RC, along with tvOS and HomePodOS 17.5 RC, visionOS 1.2 Beta 5, no macOS update just yet, and older updates for iOS 16. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General and About. As you can see, the build number is 21F79, and this should be the final build released to the public if there's no additional issues. There could be an RC2, we've seen that before, but typically this will be the final release. Now there was a new hello screen when I rebooted the device that showed my Memoji there. We've seen that before, but it does show up when I rebooted the first time. Now, as far as new features, there is a new wallpaper in this update. There are no new wallpapers for the new Apple Let Loose event that they showed the iPad. Those will be coming with those iPad releases, but let's go ahead and take a look at the wallpaper. And if I scroll down, you'll see that there's a new Pride wallpaper. Apple announced this the other day. It's contained in this update, and if you want to use it, it's here. If not, you can just ignore it, but either way, they've updated it here and on the iPad also. Now, if we go out of this, there are some new updates for the EU. If you're using sideloading, using third-party app stores and developer apps, you can now sideload via the web if the developer chooses that. So that's something that's been changed. And also iPadOS is now seen as a gatekeeper device, but this update doesn't seem to contain that yet, where you could use third-party app stores on the iPad, but that's coming soon. Apple News, however, did get some updates. If we go into News, we'll go over to News, and within News, if we go to Following, we have different games. We can go back here and see puzzles, and within here, we have an all-new Quartiles puzzle game. So if we go into this, give it a second, we can play this game, and then we can also see leaderboards or rankings. So if we want to see how we compare to others while we're playing this game, that's available in this update. There's also an offline mode for News Plus. So if we go into our settings, we'll go back and then scroll down to News. Under News, you'll see there's a News Plus offline mode. We can automatically download, and then we have some download options with recent stories or whatever we want to download, whether it's puzzles, audio stories, or we can just optimize storage. If we go back and scroll down further, we also have a new option for Game Center, News Plus Puzzles, so you can send your results to Game Center to see how you rank, as I showed you before, in Apple News Plus. There's also something new that we weren't familiar with in this update that has to do with AirTags. Apple has said there's a new cross-platform tracking detection which delivers notifications to users if a compatible Bluetooth tracker is nearby that they don't own. So it's regardless of what operating system, it will let you know as long as it's paired with something, and it will notify you on your iPhone, iPad, or Mac that it's nearby. If we go into Find My, there's a new mode here also. Within Devices, if we scroll down, you'll see I already have a device in repair mode. You can do that by swiping and sort of removing it. So if we delete, you'll see it says cannot remove iPhone, prepare this device for repair. This iPhone is linked to your Apple ID and cannot be removed while it's online, but you can still prepare it for repair. However, I would caution against this as there's no way to take it out of repair mode, it seems. And you can see here on this page when you go into a device where it says this device remains fully functional in the repair state. On the other device, I wasn't able to remove it either, so hopefully there's a new way to do that soon, but so far I haven't found it. Books gets an update, and if we look at the top right corner of Books, there's a new icon. This is an activity monitor for reading goals. So if you've got reading goals within the Books app, go to the top, you'll see it fill in throughout the day as you've reached those reading goals. If we go back home and slide over to my page here with my podcast app or podcast widget, go to the library, maybe scroll down, and maybe we'll turn the volume all the way down. Now let's play this one. We'll play the latest episode, swipe home, and you'll see that the background changes to match. If we go back to the library, go into the Waveform podcast, swipe home, it changes again to match. This is something we've had in music for a while that they've finally brought to the podcast widget. Something else to go along with podcasts is that in Spotlight Search, if you search for podcasts, you'll see that it brings up your latest played podcast. So if you're searching for that, not only will it show you the app, but all of the associated podcasts that you regularly listen to. If we go back home, you may have already noticed this is a very small change, but on this device, you'll see that the overall widget here has a smaller font. I actually like it before with 17.4.1 on the left, but they've made it a little bit smaller. I like that the temperature was larger before. Maybe they'll change that back, but it is just a small change. If we go into our settings, there's an update here. So if we go into settings, we'll go back. And then if we go to privacy and security, scroll to the bottom, we have passkeys access for web browsers. There's a new icon here that wasn't there before. So very small update, but something they've changed. They've also changed something if we go into messages. If you're searching for an emoji and you type in the word Jerusalem, it no longer shows a flag. So they've removed that in this update. If you're in the United States and you're using an eSIM, since we don't have SIM card slots in the side of our iPhone anymore with the latest versions for a couple of years, there's a new Apple Universal Link for eSIM that's available for developers to use if they want to make it easier to move things around. So that's something I'll show you later in the release notes. Also in the code, there's mention of the new upcoming Beats Pill portable speaker. There's an animation for it, and it's in the code. As soon as that releases, it will be available. Battery charge cycles and battery health on iPad appear to be coming, but are not showing up on the current iPads. So this is the latest iPad Pro that was not announced today, but if we go into our settings, go to battery, you'll see that we don't have anything as far as cycle count. So that could be coming in the future. It's not in general or about either. Apple released new iPads today in their Apple Let Loose event. I have a separate video going over all the new changes, but there's a new iPad Pro with an OLED display, iPad Air, Apple Pencil Pro, and they announced some new software changes or updates with Logic Pro and Final Cut Pro. Logic Pro comes out on May 13th, and then Final Cut Pro comes out in the spring, along with a new app that goes with your iPhone that lets you have multiple cam views in Final Cut Pro on the iPad. So those are available. Like I said, I have a separate device, and the new iPad Pro is the thinnest device Apple's ever made, even thinner than the iPod Nano. So that's something that is significant. However, we'll have to try one out once they're available next week. Now, as far as other new features, well, most of those are being saved for iOS 18 that's coming in June. So we'll see iOS 18 Beta 1 in June with a final release in September. Things they did not add to iOS 17.5 are that live activity for stopwatch. Unfortunately, it's not here. It is for your timers, but it's not for the stopwatch, where it was in iOS 17.4 betas. Maybe they'll add it in iOS 18 betas. We don't know, but I'm not sure why they removed that. The same is true for Apple Music SharePlay. That's not here on the HomePod or Apple TV as it was in iOS 17.4. Now, Apple has mentioned that a fix is coming soon to fix the issue with the alarm clock bug. Now, they haven't released an iOS 17.4.2 to fix that, and they haven't even mentioned in the notes of iOS 17.5 whether or not this actually fixes it. They just tell us that there's going to be bug fixes and security updates. I really wish Apple would update this. Let us know what those bug fixes are. You don't have to tell us about the security updates ahead of time, but definitely tell us about the bug fixes. And as far as bug fixes I was able to find, well, so far, the wallpaper dimming bug seems to be gone, so let me get rid of all of this, swipe home, and you'll see it doesn't seem to dim for me. It seems to be the same, so it looks like they may have fixed this so far. There's also no known other bugs in the notes, so if I pull down Spotlight Search, it's nice and fast, or if I go into the feedback app, they've updated it with the RC notes, and you'll see here where they have resolved issues, so they have resolved issues for accessibility, app tracking transparency, they have new features for core motion for developers, that eSIM feature I mentioned before, they've resolved issues with StoreKit, and resolved an issue with wallpaper, where when you add a new wallpaper sheet, it does not load any content after restoring the device. So all of those things are fixed, but these are basically the same notes as Beta 4. We really could use some more in-depth notes. As far as security updates, if we go to Apple's security website, and if we scroll down, there's nothing here yet, but they typically release the security updates after the public release is out, letting you know what's fixed. So we'll definitely see this updated when it releases to the public. As far as performance, well, so far it seems pretty smooth. We'll take a look at benchmarks a little bit later, but ProMotion is nice and fast. I do have this on the iPhone 11, so if we go into music for the first time, maybe load the library and scroll. Seems okay. However, it's going to take a few days to know for sure if performance is much better, but so far it seems nice and smooth with ProMotion, opening apps, switching different app pages, the animation is very smooth. They may have slowed it down slightly where it doesn't animate as fast, but it seems plenty fast as far as using it. Just going into that was very fast as far as weather. Sometimes that takes a while to load. The overall heat is good as well. Even though it installed 6 gigabytes of updates, it's still not that warm, even though it has to finish processing in the background, usually after a day or two. So it will index everything and usually rewrite what it needs to, get rid of old files after the install, and it's nice and cool, at least for that. It is a little bit warm to the touch, but it's not overheating, it's not giving me an overheat message, and it seems much better at this point. We'll have to measure that this weekend, though, in the follow-up. The same is true with battery. That takes a few days to measure, but if we go into battery health, you'll see I'm at 178 cycles with 98% maximum capacity. So pretty typical around this cycle count. And if we go to the last 10 days, take a look at yesterday, I had 4 hours and 16 minutes of screen active time, 1 hour and 57 minutes of screen idle time, and used about 80% of my battery. So not very good. Today, 2 hours and 43 minutes of screen active time, 1 hour and 7 minutes of screen idle time. And I'm currently down to 65%. So much better today. Hopefully it improves greatly over what 17.4.1 was. If you're wondering if you should install iOS 17.5 RC, well, if you're a developer or public beta tester, definitely upgrade to this version already if you haven't. And if you're on 17.4.1 and you want to try it out, now would be the time, as the RC or release candidate tends to be the stable version that, again, if they don't have additional issues, they'll release the same version to the public. We just have it early as developers or beta testers. As far as the public release date, well, based on some information we have about the release of Logic Pro and future updates, it looks like the 13th will be the final release. iOS 17.5 should release on the 13th, and then on Tuesday the 14th, we could see iOS 17.6 Beta 1. We'll have iOS 17 betas along with iOS 18 betas all the way until the iOS 18 release in September to the public. That will typically launch before the next iPhone, but of course, WWDC 2024 is on June 10th, and that's where we expect to see iOS 18 Beta 1 with all of the new feature updates. So just about a month or so away, we'll see all of those changes. So that's where all of the big things are expected. Now, any other releases, we're not expecting 17.4.2. There's no mention of it anywhere, so they're probably waiting till 17.5 to fix additional bugs. Benchmarks just completed, and we have 2,875 for single core, 7,080 for multi-core. That's not as good as what we had before, but this could take a few days to improve, as I just installed a pretty large update. So you'll see it's a little bit lower for single core, about 300 points lower for multi-core, but that will probably improve in the next few days. So again, we'll talk about this in a few days on the weekend follow-up and see how it's changed or not improved at all. Now, as far as other features, well, that seems to be everything so far in iOS 17.5, but there could be a few extra things. And of course, if I do find more, I'll mention it in the weekend follow-up. If you found anything else, though, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.